Well, good evening, sports fans. Do not attempt to adjust your monitor. There's nothing wrong with your screen. There's just no video here. Blank screen. You're going to have to use your mind to see this movie. And that's what a lot of these podcasts are, by the way. It's just like being in a theater. And you come to a theater to watch a movie, or watch a play, watch something on stage. This is the point of a presentation. That's what these podcasts are, most of them. The reason I'm talking about this is because I was, of course, listening to Matty D's podcast tonight on Friday. And yes, I have been moderating that chat room for a couple of weeks now, at Matty's request, by the way. I do not ask to moderate anyone's chat room. If I'm asked, I will help. And if not, people can deal with it on their own. But the reason that I'm willing to help moderate other people's podcasts is not because I want to, or because I request this, because I moderate other people's podcasts because I'm trying to help. You see, there are people here who are genuine, who are real people. These genuine people have truly came to these podcasts, any particular one, take your pick. They've come to this to watch the movie, or the play, or the show, whatever you want to call it. That's why they're there. They're there because they're interested in it. They're genuinely interested in the topic, and they feel like they have something to contribute. And of course, in the case of these podcasts, the chat room allows the audience to participate in what's happening on the screen. You need to understand that not everyone on the internet is here to watch the show. In fact, most of these people, well, all of the ones that I'm talking about, these trolls, none of them are here to watch the screen. None of them. None of them care what's on the screen. That's not why they're here. They're only in the audience for the purpose of throwing shit at the screen. That's why they came in the theater in the first place. All of them. It's easy to figure this out, mostly because just a little common sense goes a long way. You'll notice that all these people have already came out openly and said they hate this movie. They do not like this movie. You ever go to a movie that you don't like, and you're sitting through the movie, and the whole thing sucks, and you're there for an hour and a half, and it just you just can't wait for it to be over because it's that bad? You know, if you're smart, tomorrow when you want to go see a movie, you don't pick that movie because you already know you don't like that movie. You know why you don't like it. You've seen it. You don't go back and watch the same movie again, and you. Definitely don't go back and watch the same movie for 3 months in a row just so you can sit in the audience and yell, "I don't like this movie! This movie sucks! The people on the screen, they suck! Why did he put that person on the screen? I don't like that person. Why is he on the screen? I'm gonna throw shit at the screen." And that's why they come. That's the only reason they're there, period. When I call these people fake, I don't just mean that you're hiding behind a blank account that you just made 15 minutes ago so you can come in here and run your mouth, because you don't really have the balls to say what you think openly. You need a fake account so you can sit there and, you know, run your mouth. I get it. I know. A lot of people are scared. And if you're so scared that you can't really say what you think on the internet where the consequences are minimal, I mean, there are consequences, but you're not going to get punched in the nose on the internet. So if you're so weak and pathetic that you need 15, 20, 50 different accounts so you can go out there and run your mouth, in my mind, I mean, in my opinion, this is about as low as it gets. I mean, you are truly a waste of a human being. If you're so pathetically weak that you have to hide, and you're not even comfortable enough with yourself to be who you are and say what you really think on the internet, where there are minimal consequences,
I just don't understand how you're going to make it through life when things get really difficult. If you're just that weak and that pathetic, and I know all of these trolls are. I know that. That's, again, why they have 50 accounts or as many as they can sit around and make up. They have to have them because, again, as soon as they walk into someone's theater and they reach in their pants and start throwing shit at the screen or worse, at the audience, that's another thing these people do. I'll get to that in a minute. But the moment they come in and start throwing shit at the screen or the audience, there's probably going to be an usher or some bouncer or someone like me come along and tap you on the shoulder and say, you got to go. And then you're going to cry and complain, well, free speech, I should be free to throw shit at the screen and at the audience if I want. You're blocking my free speech. Yeah, all that game. Too bad. You get the fuck out. Now, if you came with six other retarded monkeys that are sitting there beside you, and they, even if they're not throwing shit at the screen yet, they're just sitting there laughing because they think it's funny to watch you throw shit at the screen, that's fine. Everybody you came with, they can get out too, because I know why they're there, you know? All these monkeys run together. If you haven't noticed that yet, well, start paying attention. It's amazing the connections that people have as far as who's connected to who. If you just go to any of their these troll podcasts where they sit around, like Josh, he had tonight, and they'll all sit around and just laugh and they'll pat themselves on their back and call themselves trolls. Yeah, I'm an original troll. I'm this. They're proud of this. And you can't even fault them because they are retarded monkeys. I mean, they don't know any better. They think throwing shit at a screen is funny. They think throwing shit on other people is funny. And it's the only reason they're here in the theater, on the internet. If you don't understand that, you're never going to get why this keeps happening. You're just not going to, it's never going to click to you. By the way, after, three, 4 months of watching who's who and who's playing what games and all this, 99.5% of all these, all the drama that's created in our little communities here on the internet, these are not NSA, these are not CIA, most of them are way too stupid for this. No, they're literally just maggots. I mean, this is what they are. You guys hear me call them maggots all the time. It's not a derogatory term, it's a clinical term. I'm describing their behavior. These people feed on shit. It's what they do. It's what gets them out of bed in the morning. And it's the only reason they come to these podcasts is to throw shit on people. That's what they do. Now, I've had people even in tonight in Maddie's chat asking me, well, Chad, what are your rules for being in the chat room? I don't even like rules. I'm pretty much an anarchist. I don't like rules. I ask that people be genuine. And if that's too difficult for you to be who you really are, if that's just too much to ask, if you're too weak and too pathetic to be who you really are and contribute something worthwhile to the conversation, well, then, yeah, you'll probably be either asked to leave or downright thrown out the door. That's just the way it works. It's not that these are my rules. It's just that I know that bullshit is not helpful. I know that if half the audience is filled with retarded monkeys throwing shit at the screen, then nobody can watch the movie. I also know that that's their goal. Again, these people are dumb, but they're not so stupid that they'd come and watch the same podcast, the same movie that they don't like and that they've seen 100 times, but they'll come and still pay money to sit in that theater, or even just invest the time, in this case, to sit in that theater and throw shit at the screen. Why? Well, because throwing shit at the screen and other people is what they do. Now, a lot of people are friends with these people. I see it all the time. There's people I'm still connected with who are still connected with the people who are known trolls. I don't understand this. I don't get it. I know everyone's different. Everyone sees things differently. I also know that people don't see this. See, for instance, a lot of the friendly trolls, you guys should know this by now. You've seen it enough that you should know this by now for a fact. I shouldn't need to say this out loud. you should know by now that the friendly trolls are friendly with some people while they rage against others. Some of the friendly trolls are friends with you while they rage against you under their fake fuck account that you don't know is them. You see? I've watched it long enough to know who the players are. I know who the fake fucking maggots are. I know where the retarded monkeys sit. I get it. And that's why I point them out. I was originally pointing them out because I thought other people would like to know, and then that way we could discard of this, but what I found out is that most people don't know. Even when you tell them, I can point these people out to you, I can show them to you on a list, and some people will say, oh, all these people I agree with, but not this guy here. Oh, not Aeon C. Oh, no, he's not a troll. He's a friend. He's always been nice to me. Well, problem is you don't see Aeon C sitting in 15 other chat rooms being a retarded monkey throwing shit at the screen. I do. Just because you've never been in the theater with that particular retarded monkey while he's throwing shit at their screen doesn't mean I can't see it. And again, when I point them out, people have to see it for themselves. Even in the beginning. Remember Event Skeptic? Yeah. See, remember when I pointed Event Skeptic out and said, this guy right here is trolling, and he's pretending to be your friend. Oh, no, 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 blah, blah, blah. And at that time, you'll remember that night that I pointed it out, that was a week before they got busted on camera doing the very thing I told you they were doing in the first place. Wasn't it? Yeah, just a minute. But this isn't about I told you so, because I've told you 1,000 times. Most people still don't listen or still don't get it. So you need to figure out a way to deal with it on your own. But here's the way I deal with it. I refuse to sit in a movie theater with half the audience is filled with retarded monkeys throwing shit on the screen and other people because they think it's funny. If that was happening in a theater I was in, I would get up and walk the fuck out. I don't know why many of you will choose to sit in a theater with these people or still pat them on the back and be friends with them while they sit and throw shit at the screen. They even throw shit at the screen of some of your friends' podcasts, but that doesn't seem to matter to a lot of people. That's my only quote-unquote rules. Again, I don't even like rules. Be genuine. And if that's too much to ask, then I don't need to know your, I don't care about your problems and your, whatever's in your head that's makes you think it's funny to throw shit at a screen. I don't care. I don't need to know. I don't need to understand. It's not something I'll ever accept. It's just not going to happen. Now, if it's my theater, you know, if I own the theater and I see this happening, yeah, of course, I will throw you and your crew out. And I don't care if it's half the theater, folks. That's the thing. I remember when someone asked me to moderate their chat room because they were tired of all the trolls. And I said, okay, fine, I'll get rid of them. No problem. Took me about 40 minutes, and they were all gone. All of them. All 50, 60 accounts. Boom, gone. Instantly. Well, problem is that person liked those numbers, see? And if you throw half their audience away because, well, half the audience is retarded monkeys throwing shit at the screen... Yeah, well, I like the numbers, so, you know, let the monkeys back in, blah, blah, blah. Well, fine. I'm not like that. I don't want to associate with retarded monkeys who throw shit at the screen. Also, if you notice, these people do this not professionally as in they're getting paid, but they do it daily. They are devoted to throwing shit at the screen. It's been months and months and months, and at any time, at any moment, I can pop into any of these chat rooms and see the exact same 35 accounts saying the exact same thing about me. For months, these same retarded monkeys have been throwing shit at me, same thing, over and over and over, and they never stop. It's what they do. Period. People out there saying, well, why can't we all just get along? Well, because you're here to interact in a podcast or interact in a show or watch something on a screen. These other people are here to throw shit on that screen. And there is no medium. There's no happy place to meet in the middle. You understand? So you have to make your own decisions. And everyone should make their own decisions. I could show you how to eliminate all of this throughout all the circles if you really wanted to go through with it and carry it out. But I don't see that that's what people want. I know that some people just want to be friends. They just want connections. They just want to talk to people. I get it. I understand. That's fine. That's there's nothing wrong with that. That's a great thing to do on the internet. I like to do that myself. However, I only connect with genuine people because those are the only ones that can help. When I say help, I mean help me understand what's going on in the world, offer a perspective that is unique, that it has some value that I might learn something from. Because I've sit around and I've listened to the retarded monkeys chatter over and over and over. Again, it's always the same stuff, always the same nonsense, always. And it never ends. These people get up in the morning and they run to a keyboard as fast as they can to start running their mouth, mostly about me, which I think is funny. That's how I operate here. And if you don't like it, you can get the fuck out. You know where the door is. I'm not asking you to like me. I don't need that. If you don't like the way I moderate chat rooms, that's fine. Don't ask me to moderate your chat rooms. People who are hosting your own podcast, well, you should probably be doing this for yourself anyway. And then that way, it's your theater, and you can decide who is worth throwing out, which retarded monkeys are throwing shit at the screen, and all that. You can make it up. You can decide for yourself. But I do know who these people are. And just as I've pointed them out before, and in the beginning, people did not want to see that. They did not want to believe that because, oh no, that person's my friend. You know why little Joshy is so upset with me and will rage for me there, Joshy? Joshy will rage for me until the day he dies. And I'm glad. I want Joshy to be upset and cry and whine like the little maggot he is. But you know why he's so upset? Because I pointed out his friend. Event Septic. Ronnie! Yeah, Doughboy! Remember, I pointed that out, and that night is when Josh started making his troll accounts and started throwing his shit on me. Because I pointed out what his friend was doing. What was his friend doing? Being a fake fucking maggot, running his mouth in chat rooms about me, about other people, and then lying about it when he was directly confronted. Because that's what little lying bitches do. I mean, what do you expect? But yeah, that's why Joshy is so mad and has raged and raged and raged for months and months and months. And keep going, Joshy. I mean, it's not like you got anything else to do, huh? So keep going. That's fine. I don't mind. I don't care. Because I'm not interested in what retarded monkeys think. These people are of no value. They help no one. They contribute no content. That's why they have all blank accounts. That's why they continually run their mouth in other people's chat rooms. They have no audience of their own. They have to come and throw shit on yours. What you guys need to do is decide. If you're running a podcast, you want to let these retarded monkeys sit in there and talk, by all means, have at it. But I won't be there. There's no value in this for me. So I don't need to see this. Also, if you haven't figured it out yet, the little mockery and mimicry accounts, they make fun of someone's name, and then they come in there in that chat into a chat room, and then they, oh, great podcast, I like this show. Every time they talk, they get to troll the show, and they can say nice things, and so some moderators won't kick them out because they're not saying anything mean, although their very name, their very presence being there is trolling. So you guys do what you want to do. I think that's what everyone should do anyway. I know how I am, and I know that I will never accept this nonsense that most people call their lives on the internet. So have fun, find people who are genuine, and if you're not genuine and you know you're a fake fucking maggot, well, then stay with your kind, as I've always said, just like they did tonight. All the fake fucking maggots were in Joshy's chat room, every single one of them, and that's the way it should be. They should all stay with their kind, and that way the little retarded monkeys can sit in a circle and throw shit on each other. I'm Chad, and I'm out.